We now want to simplify square roots where the number underneath the square root, called the radicand, is not a perfect square. In order to simplify these types of square roots, we still need to simplify the perfect square factors of the radicands. So for the square root of 72, if we know our perfect squares and recognize that 72 is equal to 36 times 2, we could rewrite this as the square root of 36 times 2. And since 36 is a perfect square, this part simplifies and the 2 doesn't. And since the square root of 36 is equal to 6, this simplifies to 6 square root 2. But it's not always easy to recognize the perfect square factors of radicands. So another way of doing this is to write out the prime factorization of 72 to identify all of the perfect square factors. So let's do that as well. So if we start with 72, we'll make a prime factorization tree. Let's start with 9 times 8. 9 is equal to 3 times 3, both prime. 8 is equal to 2 times 4, 2 is prime. And 4 is equal to 2 times 2, both prime. So now that we have the prime factorization, we can rewrite the square root of 72 as 3 factors of 2 and 2 factors of 3. Every time we have two equal factors, we have a perfect square factor. So here's a perfect square factor, and here's a perfect square factor. So in this form, the circled factors will simplify, and if it's not circled, it won't simplify. So the square root of 2 times 2 will simplify to 1 factor of 2, and the square root of 3 times 3 will simplify to 1 factor of 3, and then we're still left with the square root of 2. So this simplifies to 6 square root 2. So the prime factorization method is a great way to find all of the perfect square factors if we can't find them just by looking. A good example of this would be to simplify the square root of 1,575. It would be difficult to just think of the perfect square factors of this number. So we'll start by writing out the prime factorization of 1,575. And since it ends in a 5, it must be divisible by 5. 1,575 is equal to 5 times 315. 315 still ends in 5. This is equal to 5 times 63. 5 is prime. 63 is equal to 9 times 7. 7 is prime. And 9 is equal to 3 times 3, both prime. So now we can rewrite the square root of 1,575 as the square root of 3 times 3 times 5 times 5 times 7. And now every time we have two equal factors, we would have a perfect square factor of the original radicand. So this is a perfect square factor, and so is this. So the square root of 3 times 3 simplifies to 3. The square root of 5 times 5 simplifies to 5. And we're left with the square root of 7. So we have 15 square root 7. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.